Hello everybody, welcome to my new Let's Play Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. In this video, I'm going to create a new file, just for you guys, obviously. And I'm going to call it Kevin, because I've already actually taken up the name Coheed, so this way I can not get confused between my files. And just in case you guys forgot my name, which if you did, you suck. But regardless, I love you guys, so let's get started, shall we? In the vast deep forest of Hyrule, long have I served as the guardian spirit. I am known only as the Deku Tree.
I want to add that in because I don't think trees have like aliases.
The children of the forest, the Kokiri, live here with me. Each Kokiri has his or her own guardian fairy. However, there is one boy who does not have a fairy. Oh, he's cold. It's me. So I'm cold. Maybe we should come up and like it. Oh, what's this?
Shh, I'll stay quiet for this. Shh, it's a good scene. Shh.
Can it possibly mean?
Navi, Navi, where art thou? Come hither. Oh, Navi the fairy, listen to my words, the words of the Deku Tree. Dost thou sense it? The climate of evil descending upon our fair land. Malevolent forces even now are mysteriously attacking our land of Hyrule. So long, the Kokiri Forest, a source of life, has stood as a barrier, deterring outsiders and maintaining the order of the world. But before this tremendous evil power, even my power, is as nothing. It seems the time has come for the boy without a fairy to begin his journey. The youth whose destiny it is to lead Hyrule to the path of justice and truth. Navi, go now! Find our young friend and guide him to me. I do not have much time left. Fly, Navi, fly! The fate of the forest, nay, the world depends upon thee.
Kevin, wake up! The Great Deku Tree wants to talk to you. Kevin, get up! Hey, come on! Can Hyrule's destiny really depend on such a lazy boy?
Jeez, what a bitch. You don't have to call me lazy, stupid fairy. Oh, hey, wait, I have a fairy. Guys, look, I got a fairy.
Oh, I gotta tell everybody about this shit.
You finally woke up. I'm Navi, the fairy. The Great Deku Tree asked me to be your partner from now on. Nice to meet you.
Oh boy. Yeah.
The Great Deku Tree has summoned you, so let's get going right away.
Oh, this is... We're off to a great start, guys. Kidding me? Like, what is this? 5 minutes in? We already got ourselves a new fairy. Anyway, so this is Link's house, but that doesn't matter. Let's go. So, take a step outside and... That's a new day, new dawn. I think that's gonna what I'm gonna name this episode. What is this? As soon as we step outside, we're greeted by someone small and green and who has a fairy of their own. Yahoo! Hi, Kevin. I don't know why they have a redneck accent, but I think I'm gonna give it to them. I think we're gonna stick with it.
Wow! What a fairy! Finally, a fairy came to you, Kevin. Wow, that's great news! I'm so happy for you! Now you're a true Kokiri, Kevin. Is that right? The Great Deku Tree has summoned you? Oh, it's quite an honor to talk to the Great Deku Tree. Ha, I'll wait for you here. Get going now! Go see the Great Deku Tree.
Let's check you out. Aw, yeah. Look at those cankles. Aw, yeah, baby. Nah, anyway. So, yeah, that's Link's childhood friend, Saria, and this is Link's ambition to fight monsters. And, yeah, you know what? Spoilers. It's gonna happen. He's gonna be fighting monsters. Big monsters. Big freaking monsters. So, yeah. Now, the greatest thing about Navi is that she will tell you things constantly throughout this game, usually notifying you through either saying, hey, or listen. But before we go anywhere, I think we should explore this village a little bit and collect rupees, because for some reason we're going to need this, because obviously it's currency, and in any world where you go on an adventure, you're going to need currency in order to buy things like, well, just necessities. This is the whole of Z, by the way. And everyone's been down here. So I'm going to make sure after I leave here to clean my hands, because this is nasty. This is like the Kokiri glory hole. I'm not even joking. What's this sign say? Just telling you how to sidewalk. Okay, well, I already know how to do that. Doesn't matter. You're going to want to make sure at this early point in the game, though, to collect any rupees you can possibly find. Not to say it's hard to find rupees this early in the game, but it's kind of an important reason coming up. Anyway, so we find a treasure chest. I wonder what's inside. We got a sword, Ishmael! This is a little Kokiri sword. You have to equip it on the menu thing, and then it's a hidden treasure with the Kokiri, but you can borrow it for a while. You should practice with that. Basically, it's a sword, okay? You gotta practice with it. I don't need to, because I'm pretty awesome. But let me cut some grass. So, yeah, you know, I was watching Pico's 4444444444444. He's got a lot of fours in his name. Anyway, I was watching his, Let's Play of A Link to the Past. So I'm actually pretty pumped to, do the commentary for this, because, he's actually pretty timid in that, you know, I mean, I know it was his first LP, but he's, you know, he kind of, after, like, the first five episodes, he starts getting a little more confident, and, you know, he kind of builds up to his, what he's kind of doing now, kind of situation, you know, with his commentary, which, you know, it makes me feel a little more human, a little more humane with him. It's always nice. It's always nice to feel closer to those LPers who have, like, a status of which you feel like you cannot actually achieve, yet you can when you are just as equally awesome and hoping yourself that you are, which, you know, takes a lot of fooling to think that you are as equally awesome as those type of people, but it's possible, and I keep targeting the rocks, and I don't want to target the rocks. Stop targeting the rocks, Link! Link, they're not boobies, Link. Okay, there we go. They might look like boobies, but they're not. So, jump off this here when you get, like, 6 rupees. I don't know why 6. It could've just been 5. But hey, an extra rupee for free, that's hot. And, to slice of that. Oh god, I said it already. Okay, well, spin attack that, and you get an extra 5 rupees. Now, there's, like, 3 more locations to get 5 rupees. I'm just gonna go to this one up here because it's, like, the closest. But, you can go to Mino's house. There's a treasure chest in there with 5 rupees. And also one with 1 rupee, and then 2 with, like, hearts. Not containers, just hearts. And, then there's this one up here, which, I'm getting this one so that way you can have a nice view. See that house right down there with all the stones? That's Mido's house. Just in case you were wondering where you could open up that treasure chest. Also behind Mido's house, there's another 5 rupee. Also, you can get a 5 rupee down here, like I did earlier. You can do this one as many times as you want. Okay, well, I already did it earlier. And then over here... Okay, I already messed that up. So, I will demonstrate that again, like, in a little bit. Because you actually... What you're supposed to do is, you're supposed to go this way. And if you go straight across, you'll get 5 rupees, but I already touched the water, so it doesn't like me, and it won't give it to me. And if you try to go into the shop, yes, this is a shop, just take my word for it. This bitch will be like, hey, bae! Bae? Hey baby, I see you got a fairy. Let me teach you how to use it because you like a virgin. A virgin with your fairy. Oh, she's a bitch, so just ignore her. She probably has like STDs from everyone in this village. And if you go around that corner, because it's like a secret like shop glory hole back there, you'll find 5 rupees for, you know, blowing someone. But anyway, we got a Deku Shield! And I'm being like ostentatiously dirty this episode. I just noticed that. Pico, what have you done to me? Dirty my mind. Anyway, so we have to equip that shield, because if we don't, we'll be like defenseless, and we won't be able to block people's nuts from our face, because people are going to throw nuts at us soon. Just take my word for it, viewers. Take my word for it. No, seriously. As you can see, I just got the 5 rupees there. I'm going to get a little bit more rupees before I head to see the Great Deku Tree, because I can. This is the Smart Brothers house, by the way. You can go in there if you need to know anything about the game that I haven't particularly told you. And as you can see, I said there's 5 rupees there, and I just showed you that there's 5 rupees if you jump across that way. And this guy is a village Charlie Brown, as I like to call him. If you want to see the Great Deku Tree, you should at least have a sword and a shield. Yeah, what's that? Oh, you have a Deku Shield. And what's that? That's the Kokiri sword? Good grief. Well, even if that stuff, a wimp is still a wimp, huh? I suggest Great Mido will never accept you as one of us, because I'm a racist. Shoot, how did you get to be the favorite Asharia and the Great Deku Tree, huh? Crumble. Yeah, so he's kind of like the village asshole. He's just going to repeat everything he just said to you after you talk to him, so just don't worry about it. Anyway, so as you continue on here, as you can see, things, and you get the great, it's not so great actually, it's just a Deku stick. There's no great Deku stick, and if there was, yeah. Anyway, so you want to go to the subscreen and equip that onto one of your C items, C thingies, I don't know what to do, the C thing, the things, just because that's what how we work. And I want to take a few moments to actually collect 10 of these. So, I will meet you back here after I collect 10 of these, mind stick things. Yes. Oh, by the way, these things are called Deku Babas. Just so you know, man. Yeah, I'll be back in a little bit. Okay, and I'm back now. Oh, see how, like, little time that took with editing magic? Anyway, let's go talk to the Great Deku Tree. Hello, Mr. Tree Friend. Great Deku Tree, I'm back. That's Navi's new voice. That's my dog barking. Ignore the dog. Dog's non-existent. The dog is only within your mind. Oh, Navi, thou hast returned. Kevin, welcome. Dog, shut up. Listen carefully to what I, the Great Deku Tree, am about to tell thee. Thy slumber these past moons must have been restless and full of nightmares. As the servants of evil gain strength, a vile climate pervades the land and causes nightmares to those sensitive. Verily thou hast felt it. I'm getting louder. Kevin, the time has come to test thy courage. I have been cursed. I need you to break the curse with your wisdom and courage. Dost thou have courage enough to undertake this task? I'm gonna say no.